Week 15, day 5. Again, we go back to the narrative story. Now, we're going to have something of a little bit new here. Not only are we going to read from 1 Samuel chapters 28 through 31, but we're also going to begin reading in the book of Chronicles, specifically 1 Chronicles chapter 10. The Chronicles and the end of Samuel and the books of the Kings have a lot of overlap. In fact, later on, we'll actually find that there will be readings where you read one selection and then you read the piece in Chronicles and you're like, wait, didn't I just read exactly that? We do have some overlap, some repetition in the stories that are told here. The stories of found in Samuel and the Kings are often what we would call perhaps the government records, the official record of what had happened. And the Chronicles were known to be a recording made by the priests to help identify God's perspective in the same events. So that may be a help when we're seeing things that are very similar. One, how do the people see it? And then how does God see it? Well, today in this reading, and we're looking at, again, 1 Samuel 28 through 31 and 1 Chronicles 10, we're going to notice a very sharp decrease or pitfall in how Saul's transition to just utter chaos really comes about when he consults a necromancer. A necromancer would be someone who talks to the dead. Now, that would seem odd enough. That's not something we talk about in the church, but there's reason for that. One, there were laws against it, specifically Leviticus 20, verses 6 and 27, talk about not consulting the dead, that we shouldn't do that. Not that it's not capable of being done, but that we shouldn't. And in fact, Saul himself outlawed the practice. But in a fit of desperation, he reaches out to talk to Samuel, who has since passed away. It also demonstrates his own fear as the time of his death approaches. He's recognizing that God is not with him. God, in fact, is with David, his soon-to-be successor. And in a fit of pique, he does what the last thing he can possibly think to do in order to salvage the situation. But as often happens, because he's doing his own will and not following God's, we find that things become worse, not better.